Historically, Kathmandu is a very important city. Most of the tourists are coming here to see the, you know, historical heritage.
Kathmandu Valley, you know, I think I would say 98-99% have access to sanitation. But if you look at our rivers, I mean, it's completely, you know, polluted. Everything that is seaward or non-seaward ends up in the river, you know. So that's the status.
Previously, we had like 5 conventional wastewater treatment system, but unfortunately, due to several management issue and technical issue, out of 5, 4 wastewater treatment system are not functioning right now. And only one at Gueshwari wastewater treatment plant is functioning well.
The government has realized that we have to build the wastewater treatment by ourselves, and it has to be operated by ourselves. So, at present, we are upgrading 4 wastewater treatment plants in Kathmandu Valley, including Gueshwari, and we are planning to construct new 3 wastewater treatment plants in different zone of Kathmandu.
So now, the importance of CWIS or CSP, I would say, it comes now, especially, you know, it has a significance in the urban areas. You know, because it looks at the whole system.
We have to approach sanitation in an inclusive and integrated manner. Inclusive so that, you know, everybody gets access, and integrated in terms of addressing all the different components of sanitation, which would be solid waste, grey water management, stormwater management, toilet waste management.
म चाहिँ यो सिफ्टिङ गाडीमा काम गर्छु. मैले यो काम गर्नलाई 2-3 वर्ष सबैजना साथीहरू यसरी काम गर्थेँ होइन. अब राम्रै हुन्छ होइन, राम्रै कमाइ हुन्छ. जो अरू काम गरे भन्दा सजिलो पनि, कहिलेकाहीँ गाह्रो पनि हुन्छ होइन. त्यसो भन्नु नि, गाडी बनाएपछि मलाई त खुसी लाग्छ होइन. म उठाएर लगाएँ भने उनीहरूलाई पनि खुसी भयो भने म पनि खुसी हुन्छु.
On one hand, they know that they are a very important service providers. In their absence, sanitation will be, you know, it will be chaos if they don't operate. But then they are again illegal, so they don't have proper place where they can go and dispose of the fecal sludge.
अब छैन, अब अरूले पनि त्यसै गरेर हामी के यस्तो यस्तै डिपहरू खोल्नु पऱ्यो होइन. यस्तै ट्रिटमेन्ट प्लान्ट 15-20 वर्षको जति खोल्नु पऱ्यो, त्यसमा लगाएर फालिन्छ.
We don't have a fecal sludge treatment system in Kathmandu Valley. Only one fecal sludge treatment is in the pilot scale, very small scale, at Lubu. In Lubu, we have demonstrated a pilot scale fecal sludge treatment system with which there is a resource recovery mechanism. Treated wastewater is being used in the irrigation. And there is a generation of biogas also there. And compost is also used as an agriculture product. Yeah, this kind of innovative things we need to really demonstrate.
This is a really beautiful plan to work with. I think it should not be only the place for people to visit, but it should be a place for people to practice. Because this non-sewer waste management or fecal sludge management by non-sewer techniques is the next topics that we need to work on. So we have to go for non-sewer fecal sludge management and independent household level. And for that, there should be so many lubus all over the country and must be operational. Yes.
Yeah, whatever we do in terms of betterment of sanitation, the services, the facilities, the approaches should be of high quality. So that's why we are implementing this ISO standard in that municipality. This is ISO, is called ISO 24521 ISO standard, which is about fecal sludge management service, how to deliver a good fecal sludge management service at the local level. So this kind of new approaches, new innovation, new projects are coming, which will contribute to the better sanitation condition at the city level. Every citizen of Kathmandu Valley and every citizen of Nepal should think, after I flush the toilet, where does my wastewater go? Yeah. If we think, then we will understand how it is causing the problem in environment, in the public, and is also linked to the economic development, and it's also linked to the tourism and so on. So my message to the people is, let's think about sustainable sanitation, safe sanitation, and dignified sanitation.